Hi, this is a test of the Grand Berg Alaskan, the small mill. I just finished leveling it, so leveled it on top so it's flush horizontal, as well as level where it is more or less flat vertically as well. So it took a little while to hook up. This is the first time I've used it. My apologies for the breeze in the background, but I don't have any sophisticated microphone system. I'm just using my iPad. And now we're going to take our first cut and try and even out the top. I'll be using a Husqvarna 440, which is about, I think, 40 horsepower, which is a little light for this kind of a use, but it's what I have, so that's what we're going to use. Right. Actually, it is a 40cc, not 40 horsepower chainsaw. And this is the Grand Berg Alaskan small mill. And so this is going to run, I believe, right through there like so. Like that. Or like that. I'll probably try and run it like this. It'll show a little better. I stopped the chainsaw because I need to attach the Grand Berg machine itself. So first off, let me set the distance down that I want, which is going to be, I'm going to say, about there, more or less. What's really nice about the Grand Berg system is these chainsaw park systems run on the same tools they use for your chainsaw. Everything is pretty level. That's pretty good too. Now I definitely like the old Turkish saying, measure 1,000 times and cut once. So I was very deliberate in setting this up. My goal is to make a nice flat cut right through here, starting at the high side, and it should end up being a bit of a wedge. And down here, that's two. And let's see, they have a nice incremental system. Here, let's say we take a 3-inch slice. Let's see if that can be. Alright. Right in there. It seems secure. I am going to be pointing it away from me. And say a quick prayer. Father, Son, Holy Spirit, Amen. Lord, St. Joseph, we pray to you as the patron saint of carpenters, fathers, and workers. Help me this day that this goes well, but no accidents. Amen. Father, Son, Holy Spirit.
Tis the gift to be free. Tis the gift to come down where you ought to be. And when we find ourselves in the place just right, 'twill be in the valley of love and delight. Simplicity is gained. To bow and to bend, we shan't be ashamed. To turn, turn will be our delight, till by turning, turning we come round right. Tis the gift to be simple, tis the gift to be free. Tis the gift to come down where you ought to be. And when we find ourselves in the place just right, 'twill be in the valley. Tis the gift to be simple, tis the gift to be free, tis the gift to come. come down where you ought to be. And when we find ourselves in the place just right, 'twill be in the valley of love and delight. When true simplicity is gained, to bow and to bend, we shan't be ashamed to turn. Turn will be our delight, till by turning, turning, we come round right. Tis the gift to be simple, tis the gift to be free, tis the gift to come down where you ought to be.
I'll take this out. I'll tell you, I really admire the colonists, the early people who had no power tools. It wasn't hard, but I'll tell you, it's one I never learned, so I definitely appreciate the beauty of power tools. All right. Okay. All right, now there we have it. That's actually pretty nice black walnut. Definitely be able to get a gun stock out of that. Got to figure out what I'm going to do with this corner. This is not coming along well as far as that goes. This piece of wood is pretty much...
The more I look at the grain, right here is very nice.
And the grain in here is very nice.
When I freehanded this end, clearly it's much rougher, not nearly as good a cut. This is why I had the Granberg in the first place. Now, at first cut, I did fairly deep because there was a very uneven top to this, so I really wanted to see what it would do. Clearly, I got to make this a little shorter. I don't want to have 4 foot thick piece of black walnut. Not much I can do with that. All right. Let's see how that's going to do. That should give me a nice 2-inch slab.
Thank you. Okay, well, I don't think this engine's quite strong enough. As you can see, it's kind of smoking here. Kind of on fire. Ah, my poor little husky. Well, you did a good job though. I'll let it cool down, I'll finish it off. So basically, I think it worked very well. I was pretty impressed with the system. It was fairly easy to use, especially as a novice chainsaw person like me. They do tell you to use a bigger engine, and clearly this is smaller than that. I probably should have taken it a lot slower. I've done one plate, probably let it rest, do a second run, let it rest. I did one, got right back as you saw, did a second. I'm almost finished it, so I kind of want to just finish it up. But we'll give it a few minutes to cool down. So I let the chainsaw rest for about a half hour before I restarted. Finished it off. I think that'll be the last cut for us today. I think I pushed the Husqvarna to its braking limits. Let's see how this one turned out. Ah, that is some gorgeous wood. Right here at the bend. Yeah, you can probably see it a little better from there. Right here. That is nice. Now, it's very rough. I do not have a gripping chain. I probably need one of those. Pretty amazing, though. So, my endorsement of the Grandberg. I've heard plenty of good things about it. No surprise that I liked it. Kind of amazing what it can do. I do need a bigger chainsaw, so I will check the budget and make sure my wife's good with it. And Steel Country, here I come.